about to present here is a very long history, but I try to summarize it in a way that people can understand. There are so many people who do not know a lot about Sudan, and including the people who are starting to teach that are here. Some of them, they have no idea about the Sudan. So now, I just want to talk briefly about the whole country, how, when it started, all the conflicts, and why we are here today, the moment that we are here. So, since this thing doesn't work, I'm going to ask my brother down there to help me out. So, I'm going to talk about where Sudan is located in the world. Okay? And this is the world map. Okay? And as you can see, Sudan is right there. Right there in the middle. In the whole entire world map. For those who are here and did not know. And then the next slide will be where Sudan is located in the country of Africa. In the continent of Africa, I mean. So that's the whole continent of Africa. Sudan is right there. It's bordering 9 countries. The first one is Egypt. On the north, and on the northeast, I mean northwest, is Libya, then Chad, Central African Republic, Congo, Uganda, Kenya, Ethiopia, and Eritrea on the east. And it also borders the Red Sea on the northeast. Okay, you can move to the next slide. So I want to talk about basic facts about the Sudan. First, Sudan is the largest country in Africa. And it covers a total area of about 1 million square miles. It got its independence in 1956, January 1st, 1956. And for about 56 years, it was ruled jointly by Britain and Egypt from 1889 to 1955. And then the population is 39 million based on the 2009 census. The capital, of course, is Khartoum, it's right up there. And then if you see down there, that's the capital of Southern Sudan, Juba. So Sudan is like, if you geographically, the terrain in the north is desert, and in the middle, semi-desert, and in the south, it's tropical. And it has a geographical flat with few mountain areas. It is a multi-ethnic country with over 300 tribes and also over 100 languages. Sudan is one of the diverse countries in Africa. And I want to talk about historical background. The name Sudan originated from an Arabic word Sud, which means land of the blood people. The state can be traced back archaeologically for several centuries. Language studies reveal that homogenetics of Sudanese people and Arab migration into the Sudan caused the Nilotic people that lived along the Nile, if you see the Nile, to move towards south. All the people of the present Sudan contributed to this, to the building of the country. And the state was multi-religious and also multi-ethnic, meaning both Christians and Muslims, and also they practice ethnic religions. So let's talk about the present Sudan has two different types of people. Those ones are the first, like you can see. Go ahead. And these are the African Sudanese. And the second group of people are the Arabs, and these are the Arab Sudanese, as you can see. And then, few details about the African Sudanese. Of course, they are black in color. They live mainly in the southern part of the country, and they are mainly Christians, and some of them practice animism. The population of the southern people is 8 million, and they live mainly in rural areas, and their economy is rural substance, rural economy. While for the Arabs in the north, they are mainly light skin, they live in the north, and they are mainly Muslims. The population is about 31 million, and they live in urban areas. So I'm going to talk about Sudan's main problems, why we are here today, and what led to this referendum. There are mainly three areas that can be identified. First is religious. These are problems that started before independence. Mainly religious, political, and social problems, and slavery was a big thing then. And also, post-independence, we have the same two problems, religion, political, and social, and now it included well after oil was discovered in Sudan. Since I started with religion first, let me give a brief history of how Christianity entered into Sudan. Christianity reached the first area in northern Sudan, and that area used to be called Nubia, and that was at the end of the first century. It greatly developed under the Eastern Roman Empire, influenced under Emperor Justinian, made Nubia to be one of the strongholds of Christianity in northern Sudan. By 880 AD, Christianity had become the official religion in northern Sudan. That was long before Islam actually got into Sudan. It likely disappeared following later the Islamic conquest, but only after a long fight that the Muslims decided to invade the Sudan through Egypt and Saudi Arabia from the north. During the 18th century, British missionaries reintroduced the Christian faith again in Sudan, and this time now also in southern Sudan. Because Christianity first entered, it was in northern Sudan, and then went during the colonial time, then it went to southern Sudan. The Roman Catholic missionaries began work in 1842. That was after when the British went there for the second to colonize Africa. And talking about Islam, when it came to Africa, it was after 62 years later, after Christianity was already in northern Sudan, that's when Islam came there. That was in 642 AD. They went there, they fought in the Nubia area, and then they went again in 1962 when they laid a siege to the Dongola area, and there was a big Faraz Cathedral there. That was one of the stronghold Christian area there. The Nubians, of course, put a defense. However, the Arabs retreated back. So they came back again, this time with Egypt again, with the soft policy of the community and trade so that they can spread Islam into the whole country. Because they started fighting, but it did not work. So they went back and then they made an agreement with the Nubians in the north. So they started trading, and then people started intermarrying, mingling together. And that's how Islam spread in the northern Sudan. So, what happened then before independence of southern Sudan? For 56 years between 1899 and 1955, Sudan was colonized both by the British and the Egyptians, and they ruled Sudan. For southern Sudan, go ahead. Go to the next slide. For southern Sudan at that time, during the condominium rule, southern Sudan was political and economical boundaries. People at that time were uneducated. And southern Sudan at that time was still a separate territory. Northern Sudan and southern Sudan were two different areas. It was never a one Sudan at that time. So northern Sudan also at that time was political and economical ahead, because the British came there.